natural numbers and whole numbers. First, we will study what are natural numbers. Natural numbers are just the counting numbers, that is a number which you can count. Okay, so the counting numbers are said to be natural numbers. That is, it starts from 1, 2, 3, 4 and then goes up to infinite. We will see what are successor and predecessor of a natural number. Okay, so successor and predecessor okay so successor of a number is a number which comes just after the given number. That is, if you have say 10, then successor is after 10 11 comes, so 11 is the successor of 10. Okay, so successor of 10 is 11. Okay, and what is predecessor of a number? Is a number which comes just before that number. So if you have 15, then 14 comes before 15. So 14 is said to be predecessor of 15. So predecessor of 15 is 14. So you can clearly say that successor of a number is given by adding 1 to the number. That is, for 10, if you add 1, you get its successor, and for predecessor, you subtract 1. Okay, so successor means adding 1, add 1, and predecessor means subtract 1 from the given number to get its predecessor. Now we will see what are whole numbers. Whole numbers are all the natural numbers along with the number 0. That is, whole number begins from 0, then 1, 2, 3 and then goes up to infinity. Okay, so you can clearly see that here it starts from 1 to infinity, it starts from 0 and then 1 to infinity. So you can clearly say that all the natural numbers are whole numbers, but all the whole numbers are not natural numbers, because 0 is not a natural number. Okay, now we will see how to add, subtract and multiply numbers on a number line. Now first we will see how to add numbers on a number line. If you have to add 3 plus 5, okay, so first we will draw the number line. The number line for whole numbers begins from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so 3 plus 5. So first we will take 3 jumps on the number line, starting from 0. So 0, then 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this is 3, and to this 3 we will add 5. Okay, so you will get 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So your answer for 3 plus 5 is 8. That's it. And for subtraction of whole numbers on a number line, if you have to subtract 5 minus 2 on a number line, so first we will again draw the number line here, starting with 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so first we have to take 5 on the number line. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, and now we have to subtract. Right? As you go ahead, the numbers are increasing. So for subtraction, that is, the number gets reduced. So we have to take the jump towards the left hand side. Okay, for subtraction. So minus 2. So we will take 2 jumps behind. So 5 is here. From here we will start taking jumps behind. 1 and 2. So your final answer will be 3. Okay. Now we will see how to do multiplication of the whole numbers on a number line. If you have the question as 4 multiplied by 2. Okay, so you know this answer is 8. But if I tell you 4 multiplied by 2 is 8 and 2 multiplied by 4 is also 8. But by representing this numbers on a number line, the answer is completely different. So students pay attention here. Okay, so for the first question, here you have to just remember one thing. There are two numbers here. So the first number is number of units. That is first you have to remember units is multiplied by jumps. Okay, so the first number is unit, the second number is jump. I will tell you this. First we will draw a number line here. Okay, starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and then 10. Okay, so here first we will see 4 multiplied by 2. Okay, so what did I tell you? The first number is units and the second number is jumps. Okay, so jumps means what? This is your jump. Number of jumps and these are units. That is you have to take 2 jumps of 4 units. Okay, so 2 jumps of 4 units. So 1 jump should be of 4 units. Okay, so from starting from 0, the first jump will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this will be your first jump of 4 units. Then the second, we have to take 2 jumps of 4 units. So the second jump 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so this is your answer. That is 8. So these are 4 multiplied by 2 times. 2 jumps are there, so 2 times. Okay, now for 2 multiplied by 4. So how will it look? This is your number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so here, what is that 2 multiplied by 4? So there are total 4 jumps of 2 units. That is 2 units ke 4 jumps. Jaise ki 0 to 2 is first jump, then second jump, third jump and fourth jump. So this is 4 multiplied by 2 equals to 8 and this is 2 multiplied by 4 equals to 8. Both are completely different. If the question is asked 4 multiplied by 2, you know the answer is 8. But if you draw this, then you will get 0 marks because units and jumps are important. So please practice this type of sums, okay? Now we will start with exercise 2.1. The first question is write the successor of the given number. So you know successor means the number which comes just after the given number. So we will add 1 to the given number. So 980,099 plus 1 gives you, so 9 plus 1, so it is 10, then carry 1, this again becomes 10, so it will be 100. Then 80,000 and 9 lakhs. So 9 lakhs, 80,900 will be the successor of the given number. Okay. Now write the predecessor of the given number. So predecessor means the number which comes just before. So we will subtract 1 from this number. Okay. So by subtracting 1 like that, subtracting 1 gives you 0 minus 1, so we will carry 1 here. So it will be 7 and 10 minus 1 is 9. So it will be, all the rest numbers will be same. So it will be 34,59,079. So this is the predecessor of the given number. Okay. The third question says, which is the largest whole number? So if the question was asked, which is the smallest whole number? So you can easily say whole number starts from 0. So 0 is the smallest whole number. But for the largest whole number, the number line, or you can say the whole number, extends up to infinity. So we cannot find which is the largest number among them. So the largest whole number does not exist. So the answer to this will be the largest whole number does not exist. Okay. Now the fourth question, how many whole numbers are there between 46 and 77? So we have to find how many whole numbers are there between 46 and 77. So between is there, so we will not consider 46 and 77. So after 46, 47, from 47 to 76 we will count. So 47 to 57 is 10, 57 to 67 is 10, and 67 to 77 is 10. So total 10 plus 10 plus 10. Okay, so therefore there are total 30 whole numbers between 46 and 77. Okay. The fifth question is, use the number line to find the following sum. So 3 plus 4 is the question. So you already know 3 plus 4 is 7, but we have to show this on a number line. So first we will draw a number line. The number line starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay. So first number is 3. So from 0 we will take 3, 1, 2, and 3. Okay. So now from 3 we have to count 4. So we will take 4 jumps now. 1, 2, 3 and 4 jumps. So the answer is 7. Okay. Now the next question, use the number line to find the following difference. Now we will subtract the numbers. So the question is 7 minus 7. So you already know 7 minus 7 is 0. So here again we will draw the number line. First, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then 10. So the first number is 7. So we will first take 7 jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 jumps. Now we have to subtract 7, so we have to take 7 jumps behind, that is towards the left on the number line. From 7 we will take again 7 jumps back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So again we came on the 0th position, so the answer is 0. Okay. Now the 7th question, use the number line to find the following product. So 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. Okay. And you know 3 and 5. So 5 is the number of jumps and 3 is the units. So total 5 jumps will be there of 3 units each. Okay. So first we will draw the number line here. One, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. So first we have to see number of jumps is 5 and 3 units each. Okay. So 3 units. So the first jump will be here, 3 units. 1, then 3 units will be here. So easily you can count the table of 3. So 3, then 6, then 9, then 12, then 15. Okay, so 3 jumps. So 1 jump, 2nd jump, 3rd jump, 4th jump, and the last 5th jump. So your answer is 15. That's it. The 8th question is, in each of the following pairs of numbers, state which whole number is on the left of the other number on the number line. So there are 2 numbers given, so among them we have to see which number is on the left on a number line. Okay. Also compare them using the appropriate sign, greater than sign or less than sign. So we have to find the greater number among them. Okay. So first we will consider a number line. If this is a number line starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then so on. Okay. So clearly by observing the number line you can say that 2 is greater than 1 and it is also greater than 0. Similarly 4 is greater than 3, 2, 1 and 0. And 5 is greater than all the numbers to the left of 5. So, you can say when we go to the right on the number line, the numbers are increasing. Okay. And when you go to towards the left on the number line, the numbers are decreasing. Okay. So, you can clearly say the numbers which are smaller numbers are on it on the number line and the bigger numbers are on the right on the number line. Okay. So the question is 3456 and the other number is 6542. So first we will compare them. So among this, both are 4 digit numbers. So we will first see the digits on the thousands place. Okay. So here 3 is there and here 6 is there. Clearly 6 is greater than 3. So this number will be greater than 3. So this number is greater. So it will be on the right on the number line. And in the question it is asked which number is on the left of the number line. So you can conclude that 3456 is on the left of the number line. Okay, and for comparing using this appropriate sign, so this number is smaller, so 3456 is smaller, so less than sign and by 6543. That's it. Now the 9th question, how many digits are there in the successor of a 3 digit number? So we have to find how many digits, number of digits in the successor of a 3 digit number. So for taking the 3 digit number we will consider both the smallest 3 digit number and greatest 3 digit number. Okay. So in the first lesson we had already studied how to form the smallest and greatest number using the given digits. So the smallest 3 digit number you know is 100 and the greatest 3 digit number you know is 999. So, successor of these two numbers, okay. Successor means what? The number which comes just after the given number. So, by adding 1, you get the number. So, successor of 100 is 101 as 100 plus 1 is 101. And for 999 plus 1 gives you 1000. Okay. Now, we have to find the number of digits. Okay. So, here, clearly this is a 3 digit number and this is a 4 digit number. Okay. So you can say the number of digits in a successor of a three digit number is either 3 or 4. Okay, with this we finish with our first exercise. In the next lecture we will study some properties of the whole numbers for addition, subtraction and then multiplication and division. Okay, till then practice all the sums again. I will see you in the next lecture. Take care.